Bless fam, welcome back to the garden. Welcome back to a little pre-eclipse read. Okay, so our monthly videos that are coming out for every sign, we're talking, we're focusing on the eclipse and Mercury retrograde. Oof, these videos, okay? I'm just taking my time with them. They're gonna be out soon, but before that, let's just talk about the eclipse real quick because we're in between eclipses, which is always a challenging time for us. Because we are no longer here and not yet here. And if we look at what's been happening, the full moon lunar eclipse in Libra has been having a field day in our relationships. People are exposing themselves left and right, child. Oh, Lord. And we just got to sit back and watch. Watch people expose themselves because they can't help it. It's a season of exposure. They can't help it. So if you're paying attention to what's going on in your life, you're going to be able to see where people's true energies and intentions lie with you. Okay, so hopefully you've been doing the work. You've been also seeing your role in these relationships, right? And we're getting ready for the solar new moon eclipse in Aries. Now, this is gonna transform all of us, period. I can get into like the deeper astrology if you're interested. Like, there's so many aspects to this. It's not a normal eclipse. It's not a normal year. It's not a normal life, okay? We are in the midst of a lot of magic, in the midst of a lot of thresholds of things. And the strongest version of who you are is like, yo, I'm ready to ride. I'm ready to lead. I'm ready to be in front. And so all of the defense mechanisms, all of the survival techniques and tools that you might have been using, hopefully you feel that they are no longer the right tool to be using. Now, hopefully also that inspires you to find different tools and doesn't stress you out into anxiety, right? But you're different, fam. You're different. You're changing. Things are different. Like, the things you've been working for years are finally coming to fruition. And it's like, it's real. It's real. It's about to be really real. So grounding within this release is super important. It's what's going to anchor you to your divine spirit, to your highest self. It's what's going to keep you tethered while all of these things change and reality shift. Okay. So I just, you know, I want to check in. Where are we at? What do we need to know while we move through these layers of deep, intense eclipse change? All right. Adjustments are required, baby. Yes, they are. Okay, yes, they are. We cannot bring the old version of ourselves into this new chapter. We just can't. They're ill-equipped. And we know better. And we're stronger. So yes, adjustments are required. We'll clarify. A win-win outcome is forecast. Full moon in Libra. So speaking to the eclipse that we just had not too long ago on the 25th, right? Whatever you might be feeling like you don't have the upper hand in, a win-win outcome is forecast. And for some of y'all, that means no longer having them in the picture. Okay, we'll talk about it. And lastly, believe in the impossible. It's Aries season. This is a requirement of what needs to happen. And also, not only that, but you understand that impossible just doesn't mean that. For me, whenever someone says something is impossible, I'm just like, oh, you don't believe in God enough. That's all that means to me, because nothing is impossible for God. Nothing is impossible for spirit. So if what you're asking for feels impossible, and if what God has said to us is, I'm going to give you what you want or better, and you don't get the thing that you think is impossible, it's not because it's impossible. It's because it's not for you. And that's a blessing too. Okay. Listen, fam, we got to let it go. We got to let it go. Keep saying thank you as it comes in and thank you as it leaves. Come on. The eclipse is asking you to say thank you as it comes in and thank you as it leaves, and you remain here, grounded in your power, tethered to your tenaciousness, okay? Because it doesn't matter what they throw to you, doesn't matter what comes your way, this is who you are. Doesn't matter if they see it or not, this is who you are. But do you know that? Listen, asking for a friend, do you know that that's who you are? It's fine if you don't feel it. See, here's the thing about confidence. You'll never know if someone's faking it or not. He could be scared. He could be so scared and so uncertain, and you'd never know. Because what do we say here, right? We don't say fake it till we make it. We say believe it until you become it. Furthermore, embody it until you become it, right? Right now is a little bit of a reminder to you to get back into your throne, please and thank you. It's Aries season. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Where are we going? I don't know. But let's go. Okay? Let's go. Here we are. Adjustments are required. The healing. This is talking about healing. This is talking about healing right here. And you forging a way forward within your healing journey, facing it head on. Clarification for the Cancer Chariot here. Clarification for the adjustments that are required. If you have something that you've been like really, really, you're like, oh, I'll get to it, I'll get to it, I'll get to it, I'll get to it. And you haven't gotten to it yet, get to it now. Get to it now, especially as it relates to work. Mm-hmm. Especially as it relates to work. And when I say work, understand that I don't ascribe to this paradigm of jobs and careers. I'm talking about your passion and your purpose work. As a soul, you are here to do a duty that helps all of us in some way. That is what I'm speaking to. The thing that makes you feel like you're alive, like this is what I'm meant to be doing. That's what I'm talking about. You might need to take a risk on yourself in this way. It might be that this eclipse pulls it out of you, that you get put in places that you feel underqualified for, but actually, maybe you're right on time and you're overqualified. So if it's about confidence, again, believe it until you become it. Embody it until you are it. But face it head on. If your heart ain't in it, baby, it's not gonna last. It's just not gonna last. Not in this day and age, not within this energy. Okay? Now, a win-win outcome is forecast when you choose to get back into your throne of power. And this definitely feels like, you know, again, they're relationships, not just romantic ones. Could be partnerships, friendships, work relationships, colleagues, doesn't matter. In whatever way that you might have felt dethroned, placed out of your power, you get back to it. The way, you get back to it. And you need to understand that so long as you stay in your power, so long as you don't let anybody rock what you believe about yourself, you will always win. Putting yourself first is always a success. Okay? So clarification, if there is any, for the Emperor as it relates to the full moon in Libra. Yeah, tower moment at the bottom of the deck, the Hanged Man and the Queen of Cups. It doesn't feel like you're about to win just yet. It doesn't feel like you're going to win just yet as it relates to this. That's fine. This is a feeling. This is truth. And you're going to get woken up to the depth of your truth very soon. And it's going to be a beautiful moment for you. This eclipse, this is a card for eclipse, has a lot to share with you and a lot to show you. But it needs you in your power. Again, practice the grounding. Practice the grounding. Keep saying the affirmations until it's rolling off your tongue and you actually believe it. Keep showing up for yourself. Keep keeping the promises to yourself. Keep choosing you. Again, if they don't feel good to your nervous system, it's not personal, baby. It's really not. I'm on a mission. I got things that I'm doing. I'm healing. I'm reclaiming power because I'm preparing for what I used to consider impossible. What I used to consider to be impossible. I know now that that's not true. I know that I hold the key, okay, to changing my life. The Magician is the best card you could get paired with this. Because the Fool, right? The Fool is taking that leap off the cliff. This is about understanding that you have all the tools that you need in order to get to the cliff. You start to create the impossible. Because you're believing that there is no threshold, there's no cover, there's no limit to what's possible for you. I really can't stand when people say, the sky's the limit. What? You don't think there's anything beyond the sky? Why is the sky the limit? Why is there a limit? Why are you trying to put limits on my dreams? I don't like that. I don't like that. All the time, I tell my friends all the time, tell me your most ideal thing. Because I want you to go to that place where there are no bounds and you go up in there and you're like, oh my God, this would be great and this would be great. Okay, cool. Now that's possible. Put energy into it. Believe that that is possible. There's no such thing as it being too out of bounds, but it is about you believing that. You have to feel that in your bones. You have to know that that's true. deeply, intuitively, you have to know that it's true, that God's got you, that God has got you if you surrender to God, right? All right. Oh, come on, stop. I mean, don't stop. Look, are you serious? Stop it. Fam, you are too beautiful. I love when you guys do this. I love it. I love it. Do you see this? The Wheel of Fortune and the High Priestess. What were we just talking about? You need the feeling of confidence to bring in the impossible. It's the Wheel of Fortune paired with the Believe in the Impossible with the Magician. Stop playing with me, fam. We about to do some big things. I feel it. I know. And I know that we're scared, and that is okay. I think that is human and it's natural, okay? But we can still do the scary things when we're afraid. We can still commit to ourselves no matter what the situation, no matter how intense it feels. You gotta ride with you the hardest, okay? And if you don't believe in yourself like that just yet, that's okay. Dip into my bucket, I got enough belief for all of us, because you can't convince me otherwise. You cannot convince me that we are not a chosen people, that God does not bless us and guide us. What, garden fam? We ain't for the weak. You watching this, understand your power by understanding that you are of the divine. And now you're being asked to take a deeper step on that journey. Alhamdulillah, let's do it, let's go. Let's go, what you mean? The adjustments that are required, we're gonna do them. The win-win outcome that is forecast, we're not gonna stress about that person. Believing in the impossible, we're not even gonna use that word anymore because nothing is impossible for us. It's thank you for helping me get to the point where my dreams are coming to me. I just need a little bit of patience. All right, so we wait. We wait while we do the work, yeah? These monthly reads are about to be intense. I love you. Let's talk soon.